Hello everyone! What? Another news video on RoboForex channel? Yes! And it means we're eager to tell you about all the important and hot events of the new week. Apparently, people have got used to the coronavirus or simply forgot all about it. Anyway, the pandemic has become a part of our everyday life. It has hardly influenced the market for several weeks. Its attention is on stimulation measures and corporate events. The first ones are abundant, while the second ones are scarce. However, corporations may become the drivers of economic restoration. They just need to get started. In this review, we will speak about statistics. Did you miss it? About stress tests of the US banks. What were the weak points? And we'll also analyze the situation in the world as a whole, focusing on oil. Let's get started. China will have days off almost for the whole week, hence no statistics there but for the index of leading indicators. This is neither inflation nor the GDP to impress anyone. However, another Asian country, Japan, will publish some minor reports and the forecasts about inflation and the dynamics of the GDP. This may be more interesting. Meanwhile, in the land down under, the Reserve Bank of New Zealand will carry out a session and make a decision on the interest rate, thus topping off the cycle of central bank sessions in June. The interest rate here is currently at 0.25% per annum. It is low already. There is no room for a decline. Can you imagine a loan under 0.25% a year? We cannot. However, in New Zealand, this is reality. Judging by statistics, the economy of New Zealand is doing okay during the pandemics, requiring no additional stimulation. Things will get much better when the outworld will come back to more or less normal and the world economies will get restarting, creating demand. Anyway, even in the current circumstances, there is no crisis in the New Zealand economy. Let's get back north, to the USA. As for the US statistics, which will be abundant this week, pay attention to the final GDP values for the first quarter of 2020. The data will be published on Thursday, June 25th. Some say that at the beginning of the year, the US economy may have fallen by 7.4%. If it's true, the data for the second quarter could be two times graver. The weaker this report, the worse for the dollar. The US is also preparing a report on the order volume of durable goods. The report itself is extremely volatile. Even in good times, the values vary a lot. Don't be afraid of weak results. They will stabilize at once, as soon as the consumers return to the economy. We're also curious about the personal expenses and income of US consumers report. There might be a slump in both cases as well, but don't be afraid of this either. In total, from the USA, we're expecting GDP data as well as some other reports of high and medium importance. And what is happening in the old world? The Eurozone is issuing the business activity statistics this week in both production and non-production sectors. This data is unable to influence seriously the euro-dollar pair, but it's useful for understanding the economic situation in the region. Enough with statistics. Let's continue. We haven't paid attention to corporate events for a long time. Nonetheless, there is something to have a look at. For example, the results of the stress tests of US banks, which will be issued this week. Fresh tests are most likely to show some damage by the pandemics and mass quarantine restrictions. Meanwhile, the Fed may still mark the results as expected and say that in general the banks are mostly alive and healthy. Well, we didn't expect anything less from those whose duty is to be optimistic. Moving on to the global background. The world keeps shaking regularly in the fear of the second wave of the coronavirus. This is the point from which the market views the facts of new disease in the US and China. If the second wave emerges, it will start from there. Should we expect another burst of the virus anyway? If the world neglects individual protection measures, yes, it will happen quite soon. However, if the people of the countries that have already abolished the quarantine measures will go on washing their hands and keeping the social distance, nothing too bad shouldn't happen. For risk-bound assets, such as currencies as developing countries, a new wave of the virus will be definitely bad news. However, investors are so tired to be afraid for the last 3 months that no one will sell until they have facts. In the meantime, we see some positive things in oil. Buyers are sure that the demand for energy carriers will soon restore. These are just expectations, which is however normal for the market. Brent has risen to $42.60 per barrel and may easily head for $44. On the whole, oil seems to be securing between $35 and $45 per barrel, which is not bad, but the market needs to endure this channel. For most oil producers, the level of $25-$28 per barrel is the break-even point. If the prices leap higher, budget deficits will reduce quicker and economies will restore faster. And we will conclude with the cryptocurrencies. In this special world, things are smooth. The Bitcoin still fails to reach $10,000 due to the Vogue demand. The date of the Ethereum 2.0 test network launch remains unknown, and investors are watching closely the tests of their staking service. As the world of the fiat money, the crypto market is lacking a key idea. This is all the news for today. Don't forget that we make these overviews each week to not miss any video. Subscribe for our channel, click on the bell and come again. Stay tuned, keep your masks on and don't miss this summer. See you soon!